Good morning. We're back still in John chapter 20 talking about our man Thomas. And we've so far had an analysis of his lack of faith. He became a great man of faith later on. But at this particular point, he's kind of lacking in that department. And you can see the results. First of all, he was as miserable as anything. That's what people without faith, they live by sight and not by faith. Makes them very miserable. And then secondly, people of faith are infectious. They rally people around them and they create greater momentum and energy for people who need that person to lead them in the realm of faith. And that's what he was lacking as well. But there's a third aspect of faith, and I think this is probably for me the biggest one. People who lack in the area of faith, at the end of the day, rob God of his glory. In Mark chapter, in Mark chapter 6, we have Jesus coming to a town, and it was a town where he would have been very well known. And he goes into the town, and by normal circumstances, you would expect the, you know, kind of the celebrity of the area to be well welcomed and for his message to be well received. Apparently, that wasn't the case. You know, a prophet's not often respected and listened to in his own territory. And Jesus found this to be absolutely true, that there was no faith in the town. And as a result of the lack of faith in the town of the people who should have put their faith in Jesus to do miracles like he had done everywhere else. But unfortunately, there was no faith in the town. And it says that Jesus was unable to do any miracles there because of their lack of faith. You see, there's a connection between your faith, God doing stuff, and God getting glory for the stuff that he has done. How sad it is that the glory of God is dependent upon us exhibiting our faith. It's a glorious thing if we do it, but what the heck? What a miserable thing to God say, I can't even do anything amongst you because there's no people of faith in this place. What a horrible situation for God to be in at that particular time. And so we look at this and we say, in order for God to receive glory, we need to live less by sight and more by faith. So faith does something for my soul. Faith does something for the people around me. But above all else, faith brings with it the applause of God to say, well done, well done. Good and faithful servant, you've done good with your faith, and now I am able to do something will bring me glory. We are just agents to God's glory. You do know that, hey? We don't get the glory ourselves. If we do, we're in trouble, because you never want to touch the glory of God. Ask Moses, he'll tell you about that. Don't touch his glory. But when God uses you, and by your faith, he gets the glory. And that, people, has to be the greatest motive for which to live. There is no greater reason to be alive, to be in this planet today, to be a part of a church, than to bring God the glory that is due to his name. It's not because he's got a big ego. It's just because he's God. And God is allowed to do that. And when we do it well, and God gets the glory, God smiles, and it brings with him the beauty of his presence and a blessing that there is no substitute for. In your own life, have a look at those three things today, as we've looked at them the last 3 days, and I hope that they may make a little bit of sense to you at the same time. It's all about, at the end of the day, the glory of God. So let's go and do it. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Hey people, I've already said goodbye, but another thought has just come to my mind. You know, the place where Jesus went at that particular time was the place where he was most well known. And sadness was that he was not recognized there. Let me ask you, where is Jesus most well known today? We'd have to say the church, surely. The church should be an agent of Jesus here on the earth. The church should be the body that knows the most about him. And yet it's so sad that so those who know him the best or know about him the best are the ones who exhibit sometimes the least faith. If you want to see faith, you may need to go and look somewhere outside of the bounds of an average church. Churches are stuck behind the fences of bureaucracy. They're stuck behind the fences of own my own resources. I'm not going to step out in faith and trust God for anything because I've got a budget to fill. People, we got to step across those boundaries because we are the ones who know him the best. Wouldn't it be cool if we didn't just know him the best, but because we know him the best, we exhibit the greatest faith. Now you can go. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye.